I mean, we've already let the super sophisticated, realistic Madden simulation engine predict the playoffs, predict the Super Bowl, and with the NFL draft right around the corner, why the heck not let Madden 21 do a mock draft for the upcoming NFL draft? Very simple, gonna sim the NFL draft, actually go through the offseason first and see who the heck Madden thinks is gonna land some of these big free agents. And speaking of free agents, I needed to go trade for JJ Watt really quick so I can actually release him into free agency since Madden's not smart enough to put him into the free agent pool. Well, that's done. Hopefully somehow he can actually become a Titan. I doubt he'd actually stay in the division. But as a Titans fan, I can hope. But gonna sim through the free agency pool, see who actually gets signed where, then jump into the NFL draft. We'll follow the first round very closely, then simulate the rest and see if there's any crazy picks that happen in the draft. And then simply from there, simulate the next NFL season and see who Madden 21 thinks will have the biggest impact in this upcoming NFL draft. Simple enough, we're just gonna go ahead and sim to the draft. And really quick, I'm starting to post on TikTok a little bit more, almost daily. If you guys go follow me, that'd be great. Let's try to hit 100,000 followers before Xerxes does. And my last TikTok is kind of a little sneak peek on this big video I've been working on the last 2 days. I would like to give a massive shout out to Upstart for sponsoring today's video. If last year showed us anything, it's the fact that you never know what life can throw at you. And if you use credit cards to pay for unexpected expenses, I know it can be overwhelming to manage that debt. But now you can take control with Upstart so you can know exactly what to expect. Upstart is the fast and easy way to get a personal loan to pay off your debt all online. Whether it's paying off credit cards, consolidating high interest debt, or funding personal expenses, over 500,000 people have used Upstart to get a simple, fixed monthly payment. Upstart finds smarter rates with trusted partners because they assess more than just your credit score. With a 5-minute online rate check, you can see your rate upfront for loans from $1,000 to $50,000. You can get approved the same day and can receive funds as fast as one business day. If debt is taking over your life, it's time to get a fresh start with Upstart. And you can get that fresh start and find out how Upstart can help lower your monthly payments today when you go to upstart.com/RBT. Once again, that's upstart.com/RBT. Or you can simply just click the link in the description box below. Once again, that's upstart.com/RBT. And don't forget to use my link and URL so they can know that I sent you. Loan amounts will be determined by your credit, income, and other certain information that will be provided on the loan application. And once again, a massive shout out to Upstart for sponsoring today's video. With that said, get yourself a fresh start with Upstart today at upstart.com/RBT. Hilarious, I had to restart because I got to the draft portion and I forgot to put the real players in there, so that kind of defeated the entire purpose of the video. So back to this point, what we actually need to do first is see who the heck retired. If there's any real big retirees, A.Q. Shipley, he retires, Mercedes Lewis, Emmanuel Sanders, Calais Campbell's gone, Andre Smith, Anthony Levine, Andrew Whitworth, the 40-year-old left tackle, still been an absolute beast, he's gone. Not going to be able to block for Matthew Stafford now. AP's gone, Danny Amendola, Frank Gore, that's sad, Jason Peters, Jonathan Joseph, Larry Fitzgerald's gone. So some pretty big names. Andy Reid even retired, that's actually sad. So first thing we need to do is see who actually made it into the free agency pool here. J.J. Watt, obviously now, Levante David, Shaq Griffin. Titans didn't re-sign Jadeveon Clowney. I don't expect him to, really didn't do anything for us. I mean, Desmond King. Oh, I feel like what I need to do, because I didn't re-sign some Titans, I'm actually going to place some bids on the players that I actually think we're going to bring back so we don't actually suck next year. I want to make it as realistic as possible, and Desmond King's one of those players. Rob Gronkowski, the free agent. Juju Smith. So a lot of big free agents out there. So with that, everything's on auto. We'll simulate the next week and see if we actually got any of those guys. And it looks like, whoa, bro, we got Jonnu back, Desmond King back, Jaylen Brown, and we get Melvin Ingram. Now the most important part, importing the actual draft class. Now it's just simple, gonna go ahead and sim to the draft and see who actually all got signed in this free agency. See if we got anybody else. Most excited to see where JJ Watt ends up, and he ends with the Cardinals. So that isn't really where I expect, but you never know, I guess, if they offer him the most money. Levante David goes to the Browns, Shaq Griffin to the Bengals, Jadeveon goes back to the Texans. I really wouldn't expect that one. Will Fuller to the Dolphins, Marlon Mack to the Dolphins, so Tua getting some weapons, Galladay to the football team, Gronk to the Bengals, Marcus, okay, so the Dolphins are getting a lot of freaking players, as are the Bengals. Juju Smith goes to the Lions. So, Hassan Reddick to the Bengals. We didn't get Corey Davis. He didn't re-sign with us. He goes to the Patriots, which really could be the place where he ends up. I do want to see, where did, like, Cam end up? Cam went back to the Patriots. All right, I mean, it could happen. But the most important part, the NFL draft. Hopefully something crazy happens here. We're going to pause the draft. We're going to go one by one just in the first round. So it's a little bit more freaking dramatic. Once we get out of the first round, we'll just send to the end. But first pick, fully expecting Trevor Lawrence to be the pick here. And he is 80 overall. So that's nothing too crazy so far. Next, the Jets. So they're going to go with Justin Fields, and they do. 76 overall is very well. Could have been Zach Wilson territory. Third pick, Dolphins. They're going to go with Penn Sewell. The left tackle out of Oregon comes in at the 80 rated. I mean, very well. Once again, could be the pick. A lot of people saying Devonta Smith there, but that's obviously understandable, getting the franchise tackle. Patrick Surtain instead of Zach Wilson. Okay, that one's a little funky. Now the Bengals, they're probably gonna go wide receiver. They don't. They go Kyle Pitts. Okay, can't believe Kyle Pitts is only a 75 overall. Seeing a lot of mock drafts lately having this pick here. Kyle Pitts to the Bengals. Could be crazy seeing him in that offense with Joe Burrow moving forward. Now this could be Jamar Chase, Devonta Smith, Jalen Waddle, Zach Wilson to the Eagles. Okay, what the heck? Didn't quite expect that one, but apparently Zach Wilson to the freaking Eagles, so that would be a shocker. Now, this is where the wide receivers got to go, right? Lions, they get Jamar Chase, 79 overall. Still Devonta Smith and Jalen Waddle still were on the board. The Broncos get Micah Parsons, 82 rated. So how is he the highest overall player? No, he's good, but dang, he's the highest overall player apparently by two. Now, the ninth pick, the Broncos, they select Devonta Smith. They're pairing him with Jerry Jeudy and Tim Patrick, will be a great wide receiver core. 10th pick, Dallas Cowboys go Kwity Paye out of Michigan, defensive end. Pick 11 is going to be Caleb Farley, Virginia Tech cornerback. I think the Giants probably need a few bigger positions than that. Now, the 49ers, they get Rashawn Slater, really good offensive lineman. Is he going to play guard or tackle in the league? They have him listed as a right guard, 74 overall. Now, Jalen Waddle goes to the Chargers, pair him with Keenan Allen and Mike Williams. Oh my, that would be a sick core right there, trio. For Justin Herbert to throw to. Oh my, that would be crazy. 14th pick, the Vikings get Gregory Rousseau out of Miami. I'm probably butchering his last name, but 77 overall. Jace Horn to the Patriots. Kind of expected Mac Jones or a QB there, but they get Jace Horn, cornerback. They did get Cam Newton out of free agency, re-signed him, so I guess that's why they didn't draft a QB here. But they get Jace Horn out of South Carolina, cornerback. The Cardinals get Elijah Vera Tucker, guard, out of USC. Next, we have the Raiders get Joseph Osai out of Texas, 73 overall, outside linebacker. The Dolphins, they select Samuel Cosmi, a right tackle. Really haven't seen him much in mock drafts in the first round, but he's 75 overall. Next, Christian Darrisaw out of Virginia Tech. A lot of offensive linemen here going to the football team here at 19. Surprised they didn't get a quarterback. 20th pick, the Bears. They select Jalen Mayfield. There's been like, what, six offensive linemen back to back to back? What the heck? The Colts, they don't go quarterback. They go Rashad Bateman, 72 overall. From Minnesota. Now my Titans, I'm really hoping we get a D lineman. I want Zaven Collins, a linebacker out of Tulsa. He's a beast. Next pick we get I don't like that at all. Jesus Christ, that's stinky. Now the 23rd pick, Trey Smith out of Tennessee for the Jets. Steelers pick 24. They get Wyatt Davis out of Ohio State. So many offensive linemen, dude. They're like 15 in the past like 20 picks. Cornerback, he goes to the Jags. Sean Wade out of Ohio State. The Browns, they select Nick Bolton, outside linebacker. Next, the Ravens, they select a wide receiver. No, Creed Humphrey, center, 78 overall, out of Oklahoma. Next, Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah out of Notre Dame. He's actually a beast. I would love for the Titans to get him as well. There's been like hardly any linebackers. It's all been offensive linemen. Tyson Campbell, corner out of Georgia. The Bills, they select an awful defensive end, Jalen Phillips, 69 overall, lowest yet. Out of Miami, the Buccaneers, they select Carlos Basham out of Wake Forest. They should have had the 32nd pick. I forced win for the Bucks. So anyway, he's freaking EA Sports. Don't even have the freaking draft order right. Last but not least, Kansas City Chiefs, they select Rondale Moore. And to be fair, I think that would be an insane pick for the Chiefs. He's a monster, dude. Especially if they don't re-sign Sammy Watkins. You put him in that offense with Tyreek Hill, Mahomes, obviously, and Travis Kelce. Oh, no. Get him to return punts. Oh, my God, bro. That would be insane. But there's a lot of stuff that went down that was funky. No Mac Jones. No Trey Lance. Like, what the heck? There was, like, 15 offensive linemen picked there. All right, draft recap time. Let's see what the heck happened here. Did we get anybody good? Amon-Ra St. Brown out of USC. He's decent. We get a linebacker in the third round. I mean, that's not a horrific draft. We don't need a running back for any reason. We have Derrick Henry and Darrington Evans, so we don't need Trey Sermon. Now, round two here, what happened? Anything too funky? Travis Etienne from Clemson. Always say his name wrong. Bite me. He goes to Atlanta. Zaven Collins, the guy at Iowa. He went to the Dolphins. Dolphins had a great draft. Dylan Moses to the Eagles. Najee Harris to the 49ers. 74 overall. Who was the highest overall player here? We have a 76 rated Caden Stearns, free safety out of Texas. This guy, Trevon Moehrig, I've seen him mocked a lot in the first round from TCU. He goes to the Raiders. Christian Barmore, I don't think he's going to fall at the end of the second round or middle of the second round, but he's 72 rated from Alabama as well. Marvin Wilson. I mean, there's some good players available here in the second round. Highest rated was Andre Sisco, Travis Etienne, and Javon Holland, and Caden Stearns. A bunch of 76 rated in the second round, which is pretty insane. Round three, we have Xavier Thomas, right in from Clemson, goes to the Browns. God dang, there's so many high-rated players for round number three. Trey Lance. Okay, let's go by pick here. Let's sort by pick. What the heck? So, a bunch of running backs going. Looks like Kyle Trask goes before Trey Lance and Mac Jones. He goes to the Cowboys. Trey Lance goes to the Cardinals, I guess, to sit behind Kyler Murray for 10 years. That makes a lot of sense. Not at all, to be honest, like, if we're being honest with ourselves. Still no Mac Jones. We're about to get into the fourth round. Okay, never mind. He goes to the Bills. That makes a lot of sense. You know, not a team that needs a quarterback. Just, let's go sit behind, you know, Josh Allen for 15 years. Round four. See if there's anything too insane. Desmond Ridder from Cincinnati goes to the Lions. Terrence Marshall, that's a really good pick to fall all the way to the fourth round. Kellen Mond, I mean, that's kind of understandable. Seth Williams out of Auburn. Now, this guy, he could be a first or second round pick. They have him all the way down to the fourth round. Jamie Newman out of, which was Georgia. Didn't play at Georgia, but technically says Wake Forest here. He goes to the Ravens to what? Still Lamar Jackson's job. Felipe Franks, the Bucks. Apparently, he's going to freaking replace Tom Brady. Highest rated in the fourth goes to Ardarius Washington out of TCU to the Browns. Round five, Chris with a bunch of dots. I heard they did a bunch of stupid things. I don't know. His last name could be like freaking John and it'd be blacked out. It's stupid. Anyway, so a bunch of 73 rated drafted here in the fifth round. Some pretty big players. TJ Basher out of Texas Tech, 69 overall. That's my kind of guy. Just gonna kind of like go a little bit fast to the fifth round. Ian Book to the 49ers. Spencer Sanders out of Oklahoma State, 19th pick. Patty Fisher, a channel legend, he gets drafted here. I really wish I knew what this guy's first name was, but I don't. Now he had the sixth round. There's a 71 rated Christian Uphoff. We got a left tackle here. First pick of the sixth round, which I don't know how we got the first pick in the sixth round, but I'm not gonna ask questions. Another guy I wish, really wish who I knew who he was. Kadarius Toney, there's no way he falls to the sixth round. He might be a first round pick. That's just insane. That's the rest of the sixth round. Last but not least, round seven in the Madden 21 mock draft. Highest rated player of the seventh round, 68 rated, four of them. Could be decent in the league. I do want to see if there's any big names that got drafted like super late. Anthony Schwartz, I feel like, will be a higher than a seventh round selection. But aside from that, Mr. Relevant, Parker Forey. So that was a lot to take in. Like, what the heck just happened? I'm so freaking excited to see what the heck you guys think about that mock draft. And I know a lot of people have been wanting me to do a mock draft on the channel, but, like, I'm stupid. Like, I don't know what I'm doing, but if you want to see that, if we get 10,000 likes, I'll do my actual real mock draft on the channel sometime soon. But with that said, all that's left to do, simulate to the playoffs. After Madden 21 predicted offseason free agency, predicted the NFL draft, I'm excited, dudes. I'm expecting something freaking wild. Like, after everything that happened in the offseason, I wouldn't be surprised if the Dolphins end up with the best record in the league. They signed freaking everybody, but it'll probably be the Browns. It's gonna be the Browns. 100% it's the freaking Browns. So we make the playoffs, I'd be 100% happy with a 13-3 record, but of course we have to play the freaking Ravens again for the third straight year in the playoffs. But most importantly here, we did win the AFC South, best record in the league. Ends up going to the Bengals, which does make sense because they signed a ton of players you guys saw in offseason free agency. They also got Kyle Pitts to pair up. So Madden thinks the Bengals are going to be solid next year. Not the Browns winning the division, not the Steelers, not the Ravens, the Bengals. We did really well too, 13-3. Rams got the first round bye in the NFC, winning only 11 games, which is insane. Patriots back in the playoffs this year. Cowboys going 11-5. Football team improving at 10-6. Giants improving at 10-6. The NFC East didn't even look that bad this year. Ravens squeaking a playoff spot, as did the Broncos and Jets. Saints falling off after Drew Brees did retire. Steelers going 7-9. Chiefs falling off big time. Now, what the heck happened here? We got to see. Maybe Andy Reid retiring and they changed schemes or something that didn't fit their offense. I have no clue. Dolphins, screw what I said. They did awful. 5-11. What the heck? Worst records in the league. Chargers, Texans, and Niners at 4-12 on the year. That's a lot to freaking take in, my dudes. Now, we do have to go and see. Won the MVP. We had the best offense in the league. I'll take that 100%. MVP goes to Ryan Tannehill, my man. This would make me so freaking happy. Josh Allen up there. Joe Burrow, Pat Mahomes, even though they went 6-10. Tom Brady still playing as a 74-year-old. Aaron Rodgers. Trevor Lawrence comes in the top 10 of the MVP race, as does Justin Fields. Like, apparently, they're going to be good. They made the playoffs, so I mean, heck, maybe Justin Fields is a great pick for him, but I do want to see. Coach of the Year is going to go to Zach Taylor of the Bengals. Now, Rookie of the Year, the AFC, it goes to Trevor Lawrence, Justin Fields right behind him. Devonta Smith apparently had a good year as well. Defense Rookie of the Year goes to Richard LeCount. Not really sure where he got drafted, how high he got drafted, but he had a good year apparently. And the NFC goes to Dylan Moses of the Eagles. He wins Defense Rookie of the Year. The NFC Offense Rookie of the Year goes to Zach Wilson, who apparently started for the Eagles. What a weird life. Trevor Lawrence had a great year. 34 touchdowns, 10 interceptions, 4,200 yards. Okay. Zach Wilson, 31 touchdowns, 14 interceptions. Cam Newton bounced back a little bit. 4,500 yards, 31 touchdowns. Now, I do want to see some of the rookie receivers, see if they did anything way too crazy. Like, what rookie receiver had the best of years? Devonta Smith. I mean, who would have thought differently? 1,000 yards, 11 touchdowns. Let's go, Devontae. So, as a bunch of craziness did ensue throughout the draft, of course, the guys like Trevor Lawrence and Justin Fields are the ones that end up balling out. With that said, last thing to do, simulate to the Super Bowl. And it's going to be between, watch the Browns. What do you freaking know? What do you freaking know? I hate this game. Guarantee they win it too. Browns football team Super Bowl 56. And what do you know? I swear to God, this game's so freaking stupid.